Hello friends, in this video tutorial or lab exercise we are going to learn about swap memory, not in theory but in practice. So use free command -m for megabytes, or you can use -h for human readable format. So it shows you that we have system memory, that is the RAM. So this much system memory is configured for this virtual machine, this much is already used, and only 73 megabytes or MBs are the free spaces in the RAM. Now talking about swap memory, which is the virtual memory. So 511 or 512 roughly, over 500 MBs I have configured as the swap memory or virtual memory for this Linux virtual machine. And it is over 50% currently used. As you can see, only 200 MBs are free. Now we know that there is a problem with this. So if you are working in application support role, system admin role, you would get from the command center or monitoring team that there is an alert for a particular Linux system and the swap memory is looking quite high. So we have to troubleshoot that alert and close the ticket, right? So first thing is you check here with the free command. So if the alert looks genuine, that yes, there is something really here. For example, as we can see, let's suppose 80% is the 80% is the warning level, 90% is the critical level, that is the usual standard. So looking at this, we can see that okay, it is under the threshold. It is not 90% used, or it is not critical as of now. But for example or exercise purpose, we consider it as something nasty. Okay, so now let's identify what nasty is there. So use top command. So you see that it is not working immediately because I have set up a nasty shell script which is running behind in the background, and it is causing the system resources, you know, to be highly utilized. So whatever output we get from the free command, we can see that output in the top command also, in the output of the top command, memory utilization, swap utilization, how much free utilized or used, etc. But there is no column for the swap memory here. You see, system memory is present, your resident memory is present, virtual, they are, those columns are present, but swap column is not present. So hit F while you are in the dashboard of the top. And as you can see, you can use a left right arrow keys or up and down arrow keys to and a space bar to select a particular column. So I'll just go down and look for the swap column. So you see here swapped size in KBs. So I use right arrow key here, right selects for move. So I'll move it up. I'll put it just next to the system memory. Now I hit space bar, so hit enter. Now space bar, so an asterisk or star sign is there, so I have selected it now. Okay, I hit S to save and then quit. So I can see just next to the memory column, this swap column is present. Now we can easily identify that there are these commands or programs that are consuming most of the swap memory as well as the system memory, specifically this DD. Okay, that is the part of my nasty script. So we can ask the owner of this script or program, maybe it is firewall D, maybe something else. We can ask the owner, the user, that we see this script is doing something which is causing the system too much slowness, and we want it to restart or kill that process if not needed. Or if it is some application, or your maybe Java application, or some application written in C or some other language. So you contact the developers that your application is causing some problem here. So kindly look into it. If they say that no worries, you just go ahead and restart, you just kill the process or restart the service. And it is not a service. Firewall is a service. Tuned is a service which you can restart. So this PID will be released, and system resources held by that PID or process will also be released. In the case of this DD, this PID is changing every few seconds because I have a nasty shell script which is forking this command every few seconds. So this PID will change 13397. This will not remain there forever. It will change automatically, most likely, because I have set the script to run this DD command every few seconds, but for a specific number of times. So I'm not sure if that count is already finished, but anyways, you hit Q to get out of this dashboard. That is one way of identifying the processes with high safe swap or memory utilization. Now, if you want, you can take a note of this PID, use PS and P and then the PID command, okay, sorry, the PID, and it will show you some details about that process. You can specify some other options with the PS command to show more details. Okay, so this is the command actually running in the background. Okay, that did you see it here in the in a very short format only. The complete command is here. So it is creating some dummy file in the temporary file system or directory. So if I have a look at this temporary directory also, it will be almost full by now. Not full. Okay. So it is trying to fill it up. Maybe the process is already, you know, finished. I'm not sure because I have to check it. So, but DD command is there or not is still. So we can check. Yeah, it is gone now. Now, the next thing is, how do I know what all processes are consuming swap? As we have just seen by running the top command, but there are ways. Many ways. For example, you want a total count, or you want to list all the processes with high swap utilization, something like that. Okay, top is fine when you are working in an interactive mode. You can also do this top hyphen B. It will run in the batch mode, so it will show the output and exit automatically. You don't have to hit the Q to quit. So this time you will have a lengthy output here. And the process is, you know, very slow because I intentionally did something that is causing the system to respond slowly, and that is my intentional part actually here for this exercise, because it's a virtual machine. I don't have any applications or services, you know, hosted on this server, so I artificially did something to cause high system utilization. It is still showing. I hit Control C, but anyways, if you run top command with hyphen B, it will exit. You can do something like this, hyphen N1. You can specify how many times you want to run it and then execute. So hyphen N1. This time it were fine, pretty much fine. Now let's do one thing. Get into this directory slash proc. Hit ls here. So for every process ID, there is a related directory here. These directories have several files related to system resources, their status, etc. You see here, serve files are there. Now, what command line, for example, this is also a helpful file, but I'm looking for this thing, status. So if you use get command to check the contents of this file status, you will see that there are several parameters, you know, or fields with values in front of them. At the top you can see this name field, and it has the value of systemd. So first process or process ID 1 is the systemd. Earlier it used to be init process. Now go down and let's see VM size, VM RSS, etc. VM swap. So this is the second field of our interest. First is the process ID name or process name. Second is the VM space. So any other field you can pick for your analysis purpose. For VM space, we are interested as of now. So let's do one thing. PWD, we are here. So I'll just get out of this complete path. Now let's make a script. Before that, what we can do is grep for this word inside slash proc directory. We have several directories with names, digits in the names. So they could be 5 digits long, 10 digits long, I don't care. So I will put a star here, and then I will say that under that directory there is this file status. Let's see. So from every process ID, status file has been checked and the output has been printed here for the VM space column or field or row, you can say. Okay, but this is not in any order, so you can change the order. I mean, you can perform a sorting, or you can just copy paste this output in Excel sheet. But here I am going to do this sort, perform a numeric sort, and the field is second. This is one entire field, this is second and third field. So my key field is second. Now highest value is at the bottom. You can specify R option to reverse the order. So these are the topmost processes with high swap memory utilization. Wonderful, guys, right? This output is coming a little bit here because the process ID is just one, so not much space it is taking in this column. Anyways, it doesn't matter much here, but you can take this output and, you know, paste it in the ticket, whatever worklog system you have, ticketing system, and share with your teams or on email also. But if you provide the process name, it would be better. Okay, process ID name may not tell much. For example, if I pick this process ID, then I can check like this what the process is actually. So it is some pickup command or process running. Okay, so what you do now, we try something else. So let's perform a loop here. But I will need the same command again. So we have this command already. So for every file with the ls command, so every file, the status file we mean, under every directory with the PID names, let's do this. I can use the grep command also, but I'm going to use awk for a better formatting purpose. And these items I can remove as of now, and then done. So I have to modify this awk command only now. Here use I'm looking for this field VM space, VM swap, and also for name, okay, which is at the top of every this status file. So those two fields I'm interested in. Now printf. So printf works very well. It doesn't put an extra new line character at the end of the output. So printf and dollar 2 is the field name, then sum is space and $3, which would be the value. Now after end, I just want a new line, so that once both the fields have been printed out, then new line will be printed. If I use less, and then more space will be there. Okay, after this awk we need the file name, so with the path, so we can use $ and then file. Okay, this is my command. Let's see, it may or may not work sometimes. Well, error near. Okay, error near this token. Let's see what happened. For file in, we have to use the in operator here, which I forgot with the for loop. That is the requirement. Okay, so some process names, you know, they are not having any values, because for them maybe VM swap is not applicable or not found. For bash it is there, su it is there, master it is there. As you can see, for several processes, ODT, LSMOD, LSMD, SmartD. So now we have got the process name along with the swap utilization value and cabby, so that we know it is in cabby. Okay, now you can filter out those values, those lines which do not have this cabby. How can we do that? There are many ways. Once the output is there, probably we can just do this only for only lines that have this for cappy. Sorry, what happened? No such file or directory. Okay, that will happen because sometimes you have processes which disappear while you are processing. So let's do this again. Okay, something, some big line was there, right? This cannot open the file, because by the time we executed this command, this process already finished its work. So it happens. So what you can do is, this is a fatal for the awk command, of course, but we can just safely ignore this error. So what we can do is, just here after the awk command line, we suppress the unnecessary error. Now any such errors won't show up now. We run again. Okay, now talking about that, we don't want to see these fields which do not have the swap utilization in them, and or we want to just perform a sorting. You can just perform a sorting anyways, right, the way we did with the sort command. Sort on the second field only. So let's do it. When this whole thing is done, perform a numerical sort on the second column. Well, that is good. So highest values are at the bottom now. So you can pick the top 10, 15, 20 processes like this. Okay, you can further modify this script to exclude these unnecessary fields or rows. Okay, only select those which have this cabby in them. Now can we do that? Grab for k pkb only. Yeah, done. Okay, you see, it is done. So how nice it is, guys. I hope you learned something, not just about finding out the processes with high swap memory utilization, but also a little bit of scripting. Okay, so here is the complete command. I don't have to memorize it. I do it on a day-to-day basis, but sometimes, you know, a little bit here and there we might miss, so it's okay. Now you can of course capture this output in a text file also. Just use this command here, greater than specify location, for example tab swap dot log. Maybe this is something your log file. Now hit enter. Okay, now hit get command and check the output of this file. You have captured the output, so you can do something like put this entire script in a file, okay, and make it a shell script, okay, and you can schedule it using cron tab. I have already made a video on that, and run that every minute, every 5 minutes, every 10 minutes interval as you want, and then compare the output. So you will have historical data also available with you. Now that we have completed this exercise, we can conclude that swap memory, if it is a swap memory utilization is very high, then there is something wrong on the system, specifically with the processes or services or application that are holding them too much. For example, this DD. So what I can do is pgraph for DD, and as I know that I am using it, I am running it, so I know I can just go ahead and kill it. So I can use pkill DD. Now I use pgraph DD. It is still there. Why? Because the parent PID is not killed yet, only this one killed. So there are reasons, because I have created a very nasty, very mischievous script. So it is forking the DD process over and again. So for example, PSAUX grab DD. Yeah. DD, you see this DD? This is the command. Okay, now with a different PID. So it is coming up, showing up again and again. Okay, so what is it? Let's see. Just use PS because I'm the root user. So I can see PSU. Okay, so with just U, I can see it in a very well formatted manner here. So DD, but this is not the problem actually, this DD command. The problem is this bash dummy. Okay, you can show parent PID also, PPID. Use a PS command with hyphen O and specify those options. For example, PS hyphen O PID comma PPID comma I think command or CMD, and then I specify a process ID. So process ID for this DD is this, but this might disappear by this time. Right, might be making some mistakes. No, good, it is still there. Okay. Yeah, because it is creating a very large file on this slow system. And PPID, so PPID is 15626. You see this? So this is the PPID. So even if I kill this DD PID, Okay. No such process. By now it is already gone. Okay. So it is already gone, right? So what you do now, but you might still have a new process. Now it is 7 to 7. Okay, so PPID is 15726, which is this process. So unless I kill that, okay, this DD process will show up over and again. So let's kill this parent ID. I'm not specifying any kill option like -9 or something. So the default is term signal. It is gone. Yeah, because I now have to check the PPID of this ID, this PID also, but it is already gone. The problem is, guys, I have my nasty script run this every few seconds, which in turns, this dummy script has this command, which in turns is running this command. So it is also changing every few seconds. Now there is a serious problem. Right. Now there is a serious problem. So we need to kill the session for this root user, because we don't know what else is there this user is running, right? Because this bash is not the shell session, it's a temporary shell session, you can say, but the actual shell session is this or this. So let's see. Before I do that, I will take a duplicate session here. Login as demo user. Okay. Temporarily we change the color. Now we know that we have this and we want to kick out the session of this root user so that its children processes are also killed. So what we do, we can just exit. That is one way, but another way is PS again 4295. That is the main bash PID, I think. So kill it. Is it gone or not? It is not gone because it is currently in use. So we will ask this guy to kill the session if it doesn't work. We will specify -9 for a forceful kill. DD is still there. and this bash. Let's see if we have more bash sessions for that user. We have, so we can just do this sudo kill, or we can just say sudo pkill -9 bash, but it may kill the bash process for this demo user also. So better to specify this process IDs. We have many other ways, but I want to just finish this session. Nothing there. See, I'm logged out of the session now. Okay, so I had logged in as demo, then switched user to root and did whatever I wanted to. So gone now. PS AUX grep4dd. It is not there. Okay. Now use -m. Okay. So utilization will become very low now. Okay, see, memory has been freed up. Swap utilization has also come down. Okay, so you can see the free column. Now, use uptime command also to check the system load. System load has come down also. You can see this is 15 minutes load average, 5 minutes and 1 minute. So from over 200% CPU utilization, now it is 100% and it will come down in some seconds. Okay, it is coming down. So this is how we did the troubleshooting. So guys, you might not have liked that killing part too much, because we have to do some manual work there actually, and that is fair enough, because we were like, I knew what I had done, okay, but I had to act as if I didn't know anything, because I'm troubleshooting. I don't know what other people are doing and or might have done. Okay, so from troubleshooting part, how I would you know, execute step by step the commands. So I showed you some of the ways. There are many other ways, right? So because that actually that bash line was calling the script, inside the script dd command was there, but that bash was not getting killed completely. It was coming again, that bash session or the shell script session, because I was running it inside a loop at the shell. So and that loop you cannot check, right? That's why it is coming again and again. So I had to kill the session for the root user, but we figured it out that we would have to do it now, right? So that is why I explained you all those things. Now it is over 34 minutes. So have a great time, guys. Bye bye. Thank you.